Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Gharaj Event. Today I will be making mild mutton curry. This is a delicious, gentle, creamy and mild curry. Here I am not using whole spices. While grinding the coconut masala paste, I will be adding a teaspoon of mutton masala powder. Now quickly note the ingredients required. If you have still not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon. Here I will be taking 2 large onions chopped, 1 large tomato chopped, 1 tablespoon each of chopped garlic and grated ginger, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 kg of curry cut mutton. And I will be using coconut oil and ghee as per the requirement. You can use vegetable oil of your choice. Now let's cook the mutton. Heat a little of coconut oil and a tablespoon of ghee. Add the cumin seeds, followed by the chopped onions, turmeric powder and salt. Here I'm adding a teaspoon of salt so that the process of frying the onions gets a bit quicker. Stir fry until the onion turns transparent. Now add the chopped garlic and the grated ginger. Stir fry for a minute or two. Now add the mutton pieces. Stir fry the mutton pieces well under medium heat. Keep stir frying for 5 minutes. Now add the chopped tomato. Stir fry for around 5 minutes. Now add around 4 to 5 cups of water. Mix well. Pressure cook for 1 whistle. The mutton pieces are very tender. That is why I am giving only 1 whistle. After a whistle, keep it aside. Now let's make coconut masala paste. Please note the ingredients required for making of the coconut masala paste. I will be using minimum of the ingredients like coriander seeds, methi seeds or fenugreek seeds, jeera or cumin seeds and black peppercorn. These will be roasted and it will be grinded along with the roasted grated coconut, along which I will be adding a teaspoon of mutton masala powder and a tablespoon of chili powder. Here I have taken a teaspoon each of methi seed, jeera seed and black peppercorn, along with 2 tablespoons of coriander seeds, and I have grated a whole coconut. I will be also using onions which are chopped and 6 garlic cloves. Heat a little of ghee and roast the black peppercorns, jeera, methi seeds and the coriander seeds. See that the flame is under low heat. As I have mentioned, I am using mutton masala powder. I am using the Aruna mutton masala powder along with a tablespoon of Pyargi red chili powder. Stir fry the onion and the garlic. Stir fry until the onion turns light brown in color. Roast the grated coconut. Roast until it turns light brown in color. See that the heat is under low heat. Here I have transferred all the ingredients into the mixer grinder. You can see that I have added the mutton masala powder, the chili powder along with the roasted whole spices. I am also adding the roasted
coconut, adding a little of water to grind it to smooth fine paste. Here, our smoothly ground coconut masala paste is ready.
Now, let's start making the mutton curry.
Remove slowly the remaining steam from the pressure cooker. Here, you can see that the mutton is cooked around 90 to 95%. You can use the remaining stock as mutton soup. I have taken around 3 to 4 cups of the stock.
Continue cooking the mutton under medium heat. Add the coconut masala paste. Add water from the leftover masala. Mix well. Adjust the salt if required. Let the gravy cook along the mutton. When you see that the oil leaves the gravy, the mutton curry is ready. Here you can see that from 10 to 15 minutes the gravy has cooked well and it's thickened. Now you can add 1/2 cup of freshly chopped coriander leaves. Add it to the mutton curry. Mix well. Delicious, mild, aromatic mutton curry is ready to be served. You can serve this mutton curry along with rice, naan, chapati or dosa. You can also have it along idli. This curry is very light as we do not overload it with whole spices. Please do try this recipe and I am sure you will love it. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel. I will be coming with yet another delicious recipe. Until then, thank you and bye.